Hello, everybody. So today we have a very interesting change in the approach to fasting and calorie and diet-related diets. First, it's the anti-aging approach, not so much by physicians, but by scientists, by biologists, who can explain us the mechanism of the fasting, but rely most of the time on animal models. In my life, I've guided thousands of cures of people who fasted according to the Buchinger-Wilhelmy long-term fasting. But let's go back to the calorie restriction, which is the first etap, which is, of course, resetting the metabolism. Because if you take only 800 calories a day, you will lose weight, you will restore your metabolism, but at the same time, you will have some of the aspects of the fasting and especially the anti-aging effect. It has been shown that when you reduce the food to a lot of animals, from the most easy yeast to the most complex mammalians, that you have a longer lifespan and a longer health span. So of course it's very interesting. For the people, it's more difficult because they live 80 years, so it's not so easy as with the yeast to make an evaluation of the length of the life, but we can deduce that it's about the same. Now, today we insist a lot on intermittent fasting, and I think it's a very good trend because actually we have two big cosmic rhythms in our life as humans, but also the other animals. As humans, we don't see during the night. So in the 24 hours, which are the circadian rhythm, circa means more or less, and diem is the day. So more or less 24 hours, we have a phase of obscurity, darkness. And in that phase of darkness, we are supposed to fast and to sleep. And this is our prehistoric brain that is programmed that way. Fasting, sleeping, darkness, and the contrary during the day. So when you have intermittent fasting like 16-8, 14-10, or 12-12, meaning that you have a long pause in the food intake, this is bringing you back to your prehistoric rhythm. And it's a circadian adaptation. I think it's excellent. Another form of intermittent fasting is to reduce the calories 1 or 2 days in the week. This is also a good idea. It's not a fasting, but it's a calorie restriction during some days, which brings some of the effects of the fasting. But it shows us that the fasting pause has a sort of cyclicity. And it's a cycle of 1 day with darkness and light, daylight, but we have also a bigger rhythm, which is 1 year, and it's a seasonal rhythm. Normally you have seasons where you have very low sun exposition, and during those weeks you are supposed not to find food. Of course today you find supermarkets open all the time. But just think about the hundreds, thousands of years before, during the winter time, people could only store food in their bodies as fat. And so they would switch to this fat storage during the year and make a long-term fasting. So I think that intermittent fasting during the day and maybe 1 or 2 days of calorie restriction in the week, and during 1 year, a longer period of fasting from 5 to 20 days, according to your age, your nutritional status, the diseases you have. This is an excellent idea. And we are the ones who document scientifically long-term fasting according to one program called Buchinger-Wilhelmy that is made in clinics having the same name. And we give little supplements of 200, 250 calories as freshly squeezed juices. We bring mainly carbohydrates, a lot, some vitamins, minerals, some vegetable soups, a little bit of honey, but that's all. And this fasting is not only characterized by this supplement, but also by the fact that we have three dimensions. So we follow a little bit the tradition of fasting. The first one is a medical one, and we see a lot of the benefits that we know from fasting. The second dimension next to the medical dimension is a communitarian dimension. And this is not going to be given if you just do a dietary strategy. This is a fact of going away from your everyday life and being in a group where everybody switches metabolism at the same time, goes from the eating mode to the fasting mode. And this is already described in all the religions and in all, a lot of philosophical schools, that it brings the people together. You are more or less doing the same thing. So this is the communitarian dimension. And the third dimension is a dimension of interiority. You could call it the spiritual dimension. You can call it also a sort of an inspirational dimension, where you just switch your metabolism of a sort of a automatic autopilot program. It's the protected mode of the fasting, where the things are happening. You get the fat out of the storages, and you leave without thinking about eating or buying things or preparing food. And these three dimensions plus a little supplement are the long-term fasting according to the Buchinger-Wilhelmi program. And today, there is a new phenomenon. It's the low-carb, low-prot, high-fat diets. And sometimes they are called ketogenic diets. Sometimes they are called fasting-mimicking diets. I think it's a diet, and a diet that presents some of the benefits of the fasting, but it's only a dietary indication. And it's not a fast because you eat from 600 to 1,100 calories. So call it in even mimicking the fasting is just because any diet which is restrictive will have some aspects of the fasting. And so for me, it would be better to call them hypocaloric, low-carb, low-prot diets. And then it seems that when you cycle those diets, you do 5 days on a regular basis, that it brings some of the effects of the fasting on the longevity, but also on the inhibition of growth, on the diminishing of the inflammation, and on a very important mechanism that you have in all these programs. This is the regeneration, cellular regeneration. Because when you stop eating, the glucose goes down, the insulin goes down, and you come into the metabolism of fasting. We work with people and we see how they look like after 3 weeks of fasting or 2 weeks of fasting. You could say sometimes they are 10 years younger. And on the molecular level, even on the genetic level, you have now the explanations. But now that it's proved that it works, has enormous health benefits, you have an invasion of products, industrial products, either that is ketone bodies that you can produce with your own metabolism without problem and the right moment. Maybe programs with food, packaged food, spermidine, anti-diabetics, all these products that have some effect of the fasting, but of course only one. And sometimes many side effects like rapamycin, for instance, which is in study. And in certain cases, these products might have a use, but don't think that you can really fast and eat at the same time, because it's not the same experience, of course. So do the real thing, the things you are programmed for. You can do intermittent fasting every day. You can do long-term fasting 1 or 2 times a year. Then you can eat less sometimes. You can walk outdoors. This means a forest bathing, a walk in the forest or in nature is not the same than using a fitness device, even if sometimes you need it. If you have children, breastfeed them instead of giving industrial milk. And this is only in special situation that these replacement products are helping you to bridge a gap. But it never will be the same that having the full experience out of your own self-programmed health pathways. So I wish you all the best in this experience, and I hope you enjoyed this video and that we will see you again soon.